individual mark for one resource. Just a little haul. I went to a record store day this year. And when before I went, I looked what was released at that day. You know, special editions, special disc, and whatever. I must say, there was not a lot of interesting stuff that I wanted to have, especially on that day. Yeah, it was not, but I still wanted to go to record store day. I didn't go to a lot of shops because I also went to a festival that same day. It was in the afternoon. I went to a record store day in the morning. Managed to pick up some records, not the ones that were in that list, but other ones. But were there for a nice price, and I thought that pick those records up. I managed to pick up 6 records. Nothing really extreme, actually. So if you want extreme metal, I guess you have to wait for my next vinyl update. Just some cool stuff, some metal, some rocky, stingy, industrial stuff. Nothing really extreme, like I said. The first one I picked up is by Raven, and this is Architect of Fear, which is their 1991 release. Released by Steamhammer. If you don't know Raven is a new wave British heavy metal band, really long existence, like the mid of 70s, still active now. I think they released 2 years ago another album that's called Extermination, which is also very, very good. I have some more albums by this band, and yeah, I really like the band, so I saw this one and it was not super expensive, but I thought, let's pick this one up. Architect of Fear, nice heavy metal. Be speedy on sometimes. Some songs I don't like that much, but the most of the songs are pretty cool. Comes printed in a sleeve, of course, with the lyrics, and it comes on black vinyl with the old Steelhammer logo. So it's an original press. I don't think this is only one press on vinyl, if I'm not mistaken. Could be wrong, but the other versions are all on CD, so I'm glad I managed to find this one. Architect of Fear by Raven. Next one is from a band I know since my youth, I think. I really like this band. They changed styles a bit over the years, and I'm glad they are doing now their old stuff again with a new vocalist. And it just sounds back like the old days again, so I'm really glad they made the decision to fire the original vocalist. Talking about Queensryche, this is the first album, The Warning. The band started as a heavy metal band. They are from Seattle, by the way. And they changed over the years, like I said. This one is already more progressive than their first EP. for example, they use orchestration on this record, which was conducted by Michael Kamen. He also did a lot of work for Metallica, for example.
Yeah,
this is a German press, and old school sound to it, but still great songs. Songs like Warning, Enforce, Take Hold of the Flame, Child of Fire, Roads to Madness. Yeah, songs, a lot of songs they still play live, and that says a lot about a record, I think. Also printed in the sleeve, some band photos and lyrics. And I'm glad most of these records are in pretty good condition, so yeah, that's really good. They're second hand, of course, they're not new. But yeah, this is also original pressing from 1984. Good album. If you don't know Queensryche, this is one of the albums you must check. Rage for Order is a good one. Operation Mindcrime, of course. The first EP, Queensryche, and their album Empire and Promised Land, I like a lot. And of course, the latest two albums they have released, Condition Human and I think the other one was called Queensryche, but I could be mistaken. Amazing albums. The albums in between, I'm a bit meh. The Operation Mindcrime 2 is okay. Not as good as part 1, but we managed to get a nice similar sound. What albums like Tribe, Here in the No Frontier, U2K, I think that are albums they must avoid. They are not that great, so. But this one is amazing, The Warning by Queensryche. Next one is from a British band from Birmingham. And there are many bands with this name, but this one is the British one. They have released 3 albums. Started as a trash crust band. Got the first album, they have that sound. The second album was more trash metal, and this album they went another way. It's the last album they have released. This album is more doom metal. I'm not talking about death doom or something, no, more traditional doom, Black Sabbath, that kind of stuff. It took a bit by surprise, but I saw this in the store, and yeah, really amazing cover, I have to say. I'm talking about Sacrilege with Turn Back Trilobite. Look at that artwork, very cool. More traditional doom, like I said. This one is released by Under One Flag in 1989, if I'm not mistaken. It's a gatefold, so that's pretty cool. Original press. Already Under One Flag. Custom labels, as you guys can see, and it's on black vinyl. Yeah, good stuff. If you like traditional doom metal, it's not bad. Just try it. It has a female singer, so don't be surprised if you have your female vocals. Yes, they already always had a female singer, so amazing album. I think the first two are probably better because I like more trashy, grittier sounds, but I think this is not bad. Sacrilege with Turn Back Trilobite. The next one doesn't have to do with metal in any way. I saw this only for 10 bucks and I thought, let's grab this. It was still sealed, so it was brand new, although it's from 2011. This is a reissue of the old album from 1989, I think. I'm talking about the first album of Nine Inch Nails, and this is Pretty Hate Machine. More industrial sound music. I heard the first album, a song I heard from this band was Head Like a Hole, and which is on this album, it's actually the opener. When I first heard it, I had to get used to it. It was 93, 94, I think. But eventually I was gonna like it, but in some way I never picked up an album by these guys. Yeah, on download, I have heard it, yes, I have downloaded some music in the past, but you know me, I just want to have the original, the collector scum that I am. Anyways, this is an amazing album. If you don't know it, go check it out. Trent Reznor does amazing stuff with his music. It comes with the sheets, the lyrics and stuff. And the labels look like this. Pretty simple, with the album name, band name and song title and stuff. And it comes on black vinyl. Yeah, it's amazing music. If you want to hear something different as a metalhead, there's a nice heavy dark on the front, tone under it. Nothing extreme, of course, but yeah, just fun to listen, I think. Nine Inch Nails with Pretty Hate Machine. The next one is not pretty metal also. It has metal elements, some rock elements, some rap elements and some other stuff. It's just a mixture of all styles. You could call it crossover, but crossover is also used for thrash, hardcore stuff. Way ahead of its time, I think, this band then was. They also used some funk elements, for example. Yeah. This is their third album, I think one of their best, in my opinion. This is the real thing by Faith No More, released by Slash Records. This is a German pressing, if I'm not mistaken. Released also in 1989. Back looks like this, and has some amazing tracks. From Out of Nowhere, Falling to Pieces, Surprise Your Dad, The Real Thing, and of course the very famous song Epic. Great stuff, one of the best works, together with Angel Dust and King for a Day, for my feeling. They are my favorite albums by this band. Good stuff. It comes with a printed inner sleeve with lyrics and some picture stuff. Of course, it comes on black. I said it with German pressing, but the vinyl was pressed in the Netherlands. That's a kind of funny fact. You can see it here. Made in Holland. You guys can see it. It's a pretty funny fact. But yeah, it's an amazing album, and I never get tired of hearing this music. I had this one on CD in the past, but with the movement I have to have to saw this one. So I'm glad I'm picking it up now on vinyl. Yeah, I think this was the most expensive vinyl of that day, but totally worth it. I think it was 22 bucks or something. 22 euros, I mean, of course, because I'm Dutch. A great album, go check it out. The Real Thing by Faith No More. And the last one I bought, I was pretty surprised I found it for only 10 euros. Man. Cover looks quite similar to this one. Totally different band. This band was earlier. Most people know this release, Blessed Are the Sick by Morbid Angel. But this band was had this release in 1988, and Morbid Angel, of course, was from 1991. So, yeah, I don't think Morbid Angel did that on purpose. They just like to go artwork and never noticed that this is already used by a band, but doesn't matter. Both records are great, I think. This is an amazing album. This is a trash speed metal thing, music from Stockholm, Sweden. This is, they've released three or four albums, I think. Three in the early days and one a bit later. Yeah, like I said, amazing album. Sorry for the interruption. Someone came in, so I had to stop the video. Anyways, amazing record. This is, I forgot to mention the band name. This band is called Hexen House, and this is the album called A Tribute to Insanity. First album, like I said, and amazing trash. This actually has Mike Wheat on guitar, which we all know from King Diamond and Merciful Fate. And I have to say, sometimes, some songs, there is some riffing that remind me of Merciful Fate, of course. But hey, I guess he was influenced by this band. Anyways, this is an amazing album. Hexen House name was originally chosen because it was a place of ultimate evil in Bamberg, Germany. There were hundreds of witches executed in a certain place, and the place they called Hexen House. Or a few other names for it, but Hexen House was one of them. They found it an intriguing story and chose this band name. Anyways, this is 1988 pressed by Active Records. So yeah, it also has a lyric sheet. It's pretty thin, I think, but it has one. And of course, like all releases, it comes on black vinyl. Yeah, also in nice quality, and I'm really glad I found this one. And that concludes, that completes all the releases I bought at Record Store Day. I bought these releases at Diskit Records. I talked about that shop before on my channel, which is in my hometown. If I had more time, I went to other stores as well, but we have, I think, three or three music stores in our hometown. We had more in the past, but some shops disappeared, so yeah. I had to do the downloading stuff, and people, if people didn't want to buy records anymore and stuff like that. Anyways, these shops are still around, and one is a big one from shop, big shopping company. Blato is. I have more stores in the Netherlands, of course. Concerto is also a part of that chain. We also had a free record shop disappeared. Samsung Music disappeared. We only have three left, and we also have Minstel Music, which is a little store. And and then we have Diskit, of course. And this is one of my favorites to go there. I always find something I want to buy. Like I said, I didn't go for the record store day releases because I didn't want to invest some money in that. I'd rather buy some stuff I really want, which is also there, and sometimes it's price cheaper also because it's record store day. So yeah, but I managed to find some releases, so yeah, I'm glad with this haul. Normally, I don't play a lot of music here again in my videos. I think this was just a coincidence, so I'll just show the music. I'm playing Morgan Reuter by Mystic Circle right now. The first album of this German black metal band, released in 1996 by Lost Episode Records. It's original press. Yeah. Nice atmospheric black metal, atmospheric, symphonic. If you like things like Devil, Cradle of Filth, stuff like that, you probably dig this. I found some cool stuff, not a lot of metal, but my next vinyl update will be more metal. I have already found one vinyl in, and still need to get to. I don't know why it's taking so long, but I'll find it out soon. And I have one in by the release date, one in order, but it's the release date again postponed, so it's fucking irritating. I have to do a look what I've... Maybe I'll buy another vinyl somewhere else, just to complete more vinyl in that video. We'll see what happens, if it takes too long, of course. But I still do some other videos, have some ideas to do, so yeah. Anyways, I hope you like these records. If you got something to say, put it in the comment section, or like my videos. If you like them, if you want to see more, subscribe to my channel, I would appreciate that. Thank you for watching, and see you guys with another video soon. So, take care, and see you again next time.